Hello, Smooth Jazz Saxophone family. My name is Daryl Soul Sax Merle, and I'm back with another lesson for you today. I am going to be going over How Deep Is Your Love again, except this time I'm going to go over the second verse, and I'm going to go over in the style that we find in PJ Morton's version of How Deep Is Your Love. So let's listen to the first line of that verse.
I believe in you.
So what we have is, I believe in you. I is G, E flat is B, leave is F, and in you is going to be E flat. So you put it together, you have this. All right, let's move on to the next line.
You know the door.
You know the door. E, F. So we're going E, F, G, A flat. So we put those things together, we got.
To my very soul.
So we have G, B flat, C. B flat, E flat. Re sol. We're going G, A flat, G, F. So G, B flat, C. B flat, E flat. G, G, A flat, G, F. Let's move on to the next part.
You're the light.
You're the light. G, A flat, B flat. So you put that together, you have.
In my deepest, darkest hour.
In my deepest, darkest hour. C, E flat. Then you have C, E flat. Then you're gonna walk down from C, B flat, G, F, E flat. So. If I did it in time, it would be like this. All right, let's listen to the next part.
You're my savior.
You're my savior. You're my savior is going to be F, A, F, G, A flat. Next part.
When I fall.
When I fall is going to be C, E flat. G. Moving along.
And you may not think.
And you may not think. Two E flats. And the rest of the notes are going to be C. Making sense to you, and if this lesson is helping you, please like, share, and subscribe to this channel and share it with others. Also, check me out on my Facebook page. Let's keep moving.
That I care for you.
That I care for you. B flat, C, E flat. There are two D's. C, E, I mean B flat. Now we're getting to a part where it's about to get a little bit soulful and a little bit different. So let's listen very closely.
When you know deep down inside.
When you know deep down inside. So we got B flat, C, E flat. Then we're gonna go C, E flat, F, G. Now we can get to the riff part of what she's doing. G, F, and then we're gonna use that, if you have that F sharp key, we're gonna use the trill. See, on my saxophone, it's right there. But you could go, you could do it that way, but most saxophones have F sharp key, so. I hope this is making sense to you. Now we're going to get to an even more soulful lick that she's about to do now. Let's check it out.
I really do.
I really do. What she's using now is the minor pentatonic scale. So in my courses, I always remind you about these particular scales. My courses from beginner to advanced that I have on this channel, I have playlists for those. So check them out in the description. Courses 1 through 4, I go over things like this. If you're not familiar with this, go back and check it out. So that's going to be a good one to practice because that's that blues sound. Get it in you. Play it. So now we're down to the last couple of pieces of a line that's going to end the verse. So she's saying, need you to show. She goes up there. So, need you is going to be G, B flat. You got that? All right, here we go now. We're walking up that major pentatonic scale a lot. C, E flat, F, G. Now, the tricky part that she does, we're gonna go all the way up to E flat. So we're gonna go. So after we got that part, that da da da, it's gonna be B flat, C, E flat. So. I hope this lesson has made sense to you, because when I break down some of these songs like this, if I take a long time, the video gets really long and you might get lost in the sauce along the way. But remember, you can rewind this. YouTube allows you to slow it down. Check out these licks. Remember, you gotta make it sing. This sounds like nothing if you don't try to make it sing like a singer. So now let me try to give you a demonstration. Just give you a demonstration of the whole thing. Give you a demonstration of this track now with the backing track that I'll leave the link in the description for you. I may play it slightly different. Remember how I taught you? I've been playing the song my own way for a long time, so don't get messed up by how I do it if I do it just slightly different, you know, because everything is okay for you to interpret in your own way and sing it in your own way. So here we go. Something. Keep sticking with me on this channel. I'm trying to continue to provide you with lessons that make sense on how to play smooth jazz and gospel in ways that make sense and easy to understand. Let me know in the comments if you like this lesson, and let me know if there's any other things that you might would like to see me do on this channel that will be helpful to you, whether you're a beginner or a little more advanced as it pertains to smooth jazz and gospel. Until next time, peace.